My name is Eva Koťátková, and I'm a visual artist coming from Prague, Czech Republic. At the moment, we are in the exhibition which is called How Many Giraffes Are in the Air We Breathe. I have an exhibition at the National Gallery at the moment where visitors are invited to share stories. I've discovered one story in particular that I found really intriguing and strong. It was a story of a giraffe which was captured in Kenya in 1954. Transported to the Prague Zoo to become the first Czechoslovak giraffe. She survived only 2 years in captivity and was then donated to the National History Museum in Prague. And apparently during the taxidermy process, her bodily remnants were released into the public sewage system and caused a contamination in the public space. In reaction to that, the public square had to be closed down temporarily. I was immediately fascinated by the story, not only because it speaks so much about how we approach the natural world through power and exploitation processes and the different types of violence that we apply or the modern human world, but also I saw a huge potential in the story in a metaphorical way, because it makes us to think, and this is already this brings us to the title of this exhibition, to think about how many other giraffes are potentially in the air we all breathe, how many other invisible or hidden stories or narratives or marginalized voices that talk about violence and oppression in this world are there, and we are just not aware about them. I started to think about how to translate the whole story into something physical, which is my language. How to also activate senses of the visitors in relation to the story. So how to bring the sense of touch, for example, in the exhibition. So the obvious way how to present the case would be to actually transport the giraffe here. This is an approach which would repeat the same colonial and power relationship of violence that was already applied on the giraffe, and I don't want to repeat that. Even sort of course, the encounter with the physical giraffe as an object was very strong for me personally. But I decided to translate it into something a bit more sculptural and sensual in the space, and I scanned the original giraffe and its bones, and did some casting. I also created a textile piece which is a kind of enlarged version of the giraffe's skin. So this is a portion of or a part of the installation which can be also inhabited by the visitors. In the exhibition space there will be invitations or possibilities how to enter the story through two audio recordings. One is an audio recording of a narrator who connects the story of Lenka the giraffe with a fictional character, Lenka the custodian in National History Museum. The other audio story or narrative in the exhibition space was done collaboratively with a group of children from Nottingham who were willing to contribute with their ideas and imaginations about how, first about what the story of Lenka does to them, so what it makes emotionally like. And then another layer is their imaginations about how the story could potentially happen differently. For example, Lenka turning back to life and living somewhere in a faraway land in a forest and so on. Or for example, about animal hunters turning into giraffes themselves. This is a story which I found particularly beautiful. So seeing nature as a protector of animals and other modern human beings. Critical imagination and storytelling plays really a crucial part in my artistic practice. I consider storytelling as a very important tool how to connect, how to relate to others. And for me, imagination is not a way how to escape to some faraway, comfortable lens of dreaming, which can be very very relaxing for a moment. But as soon as we are back to the same set of problems we were facing before, and nothing actually changes, but I see imagination as a very important tool, which brings up the critical question, what if, which is very often used in fairy tales, but I think it should be something that should be also used in like in our everyday realm, to be asking what if we do that and that, what would change. Imagination is a very important phase in the process of changing something, to try to put together the set of options and also our visions, how we imagine the world to be, and why is it that it's not like that, and what can we do to achieve that? Think for yourself, where are you in the story, what is your relation, and how, if maybe you have other stories that you would like to share with us, and to kind of continue the narrative, to build a kind of collage or cacophony of voices.